Hello everyone, today we are going to proceed towards the numericals of equations of motion. In our previous lecture we discussed about the graphical method to find the equations of motion by graphical method. In this lecture we are going to proceed towards the numerical of equations of motion, and we will proceed towards the next topic, that is uniform circular motion. Okay, so I am making some numericals. So one numerical is, let us take a numerical, question number one. The numerical is, a racing car, has uniform acceleration of 4 meter per second square. Okay, what distance will it cover in 10 second of after it start? Okay, 10 second after its start. This is the numerical. So see, whenever you are solving the numerical, keep one thing in your mind, that we should note down whatever things are given and what the question is asking, because it will be convenient for us to solve the numerical. So first of all, we'll see here that what is given. So what is given here, first of all, a car is having a uniform acceleration of 4 meter per second. So what is given here, A is given, that is 4 meter per second square. Okay, this is given. Then what distance it will cover in 10 second, time is given, that is your 10 second. Okay, after the start, see, now the object is starting from rest, because see, in these type of question, some of the values are hidden. We have to read the question carefully and understand from that whatever things are given. So in this question it is not written that the object is having initial velocity is 0. So whenever the object is starting, it is having some, if it would have some velocity, it will be given. If it is not given, so it means that the object is starting from rest. So the object is starting from rest means u is your 0, initial velocity is your 0, and what we have to calculate, here the distance we have to find. Okay, now we'll use the equation. Which equation we are going to use? See, to know that which equation will be used in which numerical, first of all, for that what we have to see, whatever values are given and what is asked. So what is given, A is given, T is given, U is given, and S is given. So to calculate the distance, we are having two equations. What are those equations? Second equation and third equation. But in third equation, time is not there and time is given to us. So we'll use what equation, which equation we are going to use? We are going to use the second equation. So you will write here, using second equation of motion. Hum second equation ko use karenge. Okay, so the equation, what is the equation? S is equal to u plus, S is equal to ut plus half at square. This is your second equation. So we'll put the values. S we have to find, u is given, that is 0, time is given, that is 10, plus half, a is your 4, and t is your 10 into 10, 10, t square, it is 10 into 10. So from here it will be 2 times, s will be 0, from here it will be, this will value be 0, plus it will become 2 into 10 into 10, it will be 200, so the s will be 200 meters. What is the distance from here? This is your 200 meters. Kitne distance hai? 200 meters hogi. Okay, this is the numerical. Again, I am telling what is given here in this question. We are having the acceleration, time is given, initial velocity is given, distance we have to find. So for this, we are going to use the second equation, because time is given. So we will be using second equation, that is S is equal to ut plus half at square. So we'll write the value, we'll put the values, and we'll calculate, we'll get the result, that is S is equal to 200 meters. Okay, now we'll proceed towards the next numerical. We'll write down the numerical. You can note it down in this numerical, and pause the video and then note it down. Okay, you pause the video and note it down. Now we'll proceed towards the next numerical, that is What is the next numerical? Find the initial velocity. Find the initial velocity of a car. Which is stopped. In 10 seconds. After applying brake. After applying brakes, the retardation. The retardation is 2.5 meter per second square. What is the retardation? 2.5 meter per second square. Okay. Now see. In this question, what is given? What is given here? First of all, he is asking. What he is asking? Find the initial velocity. So we have to find the u. U हमें find करना है. Then initial velocity of a car which is stopped in 10 second. Which is stopped in 10 second. 10 second में वो stop हो गई. 10 second. Okay, time is given. Then after applying the brakes, the retardation is 2.5 meter per second square. Now retardation is given, that is acceleration, that is negative acceleration, so it will be minus 2.5 meter per second square. Okay, now see, u is given, t is given, a is given. Then what else is given here in this question? Term is there which is hidden in this question, that is after applying the brake, when we'll apply the, suppose you are riding a bicycle, you will apply the brake, so after some time what will happen, your bicycle will stop, so means your final velocity will be zero. So here also, when we'll apply the brake in the car will stop, and when the car will stop, so final velocity will be zero. So what else is given here in this question? That is V is equal to zero, final velocity is zero. Now see, which equation we are going to use to calculate the value of initial velocity? U is given, T is given, A is given, and U we have to find, T is given, A is given, and V is given. So see, these terms are in your first equation of motion. So we'll use the first equation. Using first equation of motion, हम पहली equation को use करेंगे. Okay, so first equation of motion is, what is the first equation? That is V is equal to U plus AT. Okay, now after this I am solving it here. Now see, V is equal to U plus AT. V is given, that is 0. U we have to find, plus A. What is A? Minus 2.5 into time is 10. So from here this will become, I will bring it this side, minus U, and this will become 25. That will be minus 25. This will be cancelled out. So U will be here 25 meter per second. Don't forget to write the unit. Unit is very important to write in the answer. Okay, final answer, there should be unit, or whatever thing is asked. If distance is asked, so you will write the unit of distance, and if velocity is asked, you will write the unit of velocity. So in this question, the initial velocity we have to calculate. The car was having the acceleration of 2.5, that is the retardation after applying the brake, and it has stopped after 10 seconds. So initial velocity we have to find, time is given, acceleration was given, and your final velocity was given, because when we are going to apply the brakes, that the object or whatever thing in which we are driving, it will stop. So from here the final velocity was 0. We have used the first equation of motion and we have calculated the value, that is your u. Now we'll proceed towards the next lecture, next question. Okay, so the next question I'll write in the board. What is the next question? Okay, so your next question is, a train traveling at 20 meter per second. Okay, the question is, third question, a train traveling at 20 meter per second. So the speed of the train is given, it is traveling at a speed of 20 meter per second, is accelerated at 0.5 meter per second. Okay, it is accelerated at 0.5 meter per second for 30 seconds. For 30 seconds. Okay. How far will the train will travel? So he is asking how far will the train will travel? Okay, this we have to calculate. कितनी दूर तक ट्रेन जाएगी हमें निकालना है. The question is asking that a train is traveling at a speed of 20 meter per second. It is having an it is being accelerated at a rate of 0.5 meter per second square for 30 seconds. How far will it travel? So we have to calculate the distance from here. So thus we'll write here what is given. So what is given here initially, the initial velocity is given, that is 20 meter per second. Then what is given, acceleration a is given, that is 0.5 meter per second square. Okay, here we'll write square. Okay, for 30 second time is given, that is 30 seconds, and we have to find the distance. We have to find the distance. So see again, what is given, initial velocity is given, acceleration is given, and time is given. So which equation we are going to use? We are going to use the second equation. We'll write here using second equation of motion. हम second equation को use करेंगे. So what is the second equation? Second equation is s is equal to ut plus half at square. Okay. So see students, when you are going to do the numericals, आप जब जैसे आप numerical करेंगे, then only you are going to remember these equations also. Okay. And then you will get the idea how to solve the numericals. Until and unless you are not going to practice more numericals, you will not get the idea how to solve the numericals. Okay, starting you will feel a little bit problem, but go through it properly, read the question properly, see whatever the things are being asked, note it down, and whatever things are being given, note it down. Then also then see which question can be used. Now see in this question, s we have to calculate. Okay, u is given, that is 20, and time is given, that is 30. Okay, plus half. A is given, that is 0.5. Okay, I can write this 0.5 into is equal to 1.2 into time is given, that is 30 into 30. Okay, so it is 15 times. This are also 15 times. So this will be 600. Okay, plus this will be 225. 15 to 15, this will be 225. So s will be equal to 5 and 2 and 8. Okay, so this will be 825 meters. This will be the distance traveled by the object. This is the distance traveled by the object, that is our train. Train will travel 825 meter in how many seconds? 30 seconds. Okay, so this is the question. These type of question you will be doing from your book. There are questions related to your equations of motion. To try these questions, then we'll proceed to the next topic. Okay, we'll proceed to the next topic. Now what is the next topic? This is very interesting topic and the last topic of this chapter. Ye aapke chapter ka last topic hai, as well as it is very interesting also. Okay, so now the heading is your uniform circular motion. Uniform circular motion. Theek hai, heading kya hai? Uniform circular motion. Now see what is uniform circular motion. Uniform means, what does uniform means? Uniform means ek jaisa. Theek hai, we have already discussed uniform motion earlier. Okay, there we I told you that when an object is traveling equal distance and equal interval of time, that is known as uniform motion. Now we are going to talk about uniform circular motion. Now uniform, you know. Now circular motion, whenever an object, what is circular motion? Whenever an object is traveling in a circular path. Agar koi object ek circular path mein travel karta hai, so that type of motion is known as uniform circular motion. Usko kaisa motion bolenge hum? Circular motion bolenge. And when the speed remains the same, when the object is traveling in a circular motion, your speed remains the same, that's why it is known as uniform circular motion. ठीक है, स्पीड क्या है आपकी, एक जैसी रहती है. नाउ देयर इज अ लिटिल बिट ट्विस्ट इन दिस टॉपिक, दैट द स्पीड रिमेंस द सेम थ्रू आउट द मोशन इन अ सर्कुलर मोशन. आपका जो सर्कुलर मोशन है उसमें स्पीड क्या रहती है, सेम रहती है, बट द वेलोसिटी चेंजेस एट एवरी इंस्टेंट ऑफ टाइम. नाउ वी विल डिस्कस दैट. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल यू राइट द डेफिनेशन. व्हेन सर्कुलर मोशन मिलते हैं, सर्कुलर मोशन। सर्कुलर मोशन क्या होता है? व्हेन एन ऑब्जेक्ट ट्रेवल्स इन अ सर्कुलर पाथ, जब ऑब्जेक्ट हमारा सर्कुलर पाथ में ट्रेवल करता है, सो दैट टाइप ऑफ मोशन इज नोन एज सर्कुलर मोशन। नाउ नेक्स्ट इज योर यूनिफॉर्म सर्कुलर मोशन, व्हेन एन ऑब्जेक्ट इज हैविंग अ कांस्टेंट स्पीड, यूनिफॉर्म सर्कुलर मोशन। यूनिफॉर्म सर्कुलर मोशन क्या हो गया? व्हेन एन ऑब्जेक्ट मूव इन सर्कुलर पाथ विद यूनिफॉर्म व्हाट स्पीड। ओके, जब आपका ऑब्जेक्ट यूनिफॉर्म सर्कुलर मोशन में यूनिफॉर्म स्पीड से चल रहा होता है, इट अ कॉन्स्टेंट, यू कैन राइट कॉन्स्टेंट ऑल्सो, कॉन्स्टेंट, ओके, कॉन्स्टेंट स्पीड, सो दैट टाइप ऑफ मोशन इज नोन एज यूनिफॉर्म सर्कुलर मोशन। Now we'll discuss that I told you that speed remains the same when we are moving in a circular path, the speed remains the same but the velocity is changing. Why? See, now remember the first day what we discussed, that velocity depends upon what? It depends upon the initial and the final position, and velocity is related to displacement, and displacement is related to distance, length as well as the direction. It is telling the direction, and velocity is the speed which has the direction. So हम यहाँ पर direction की बात भी कर रहे हैं। अब देखो, now we'll take the example like this. This is your circular motion. This is your circular path. An object is placed like here. Okay, he is traveling in a circular path. Right now the direction of the object is like this. ऐसे करके direction मारा। Now when he has reached this position, the direction is this. Now when he has reached this position, the direction is this. And when the object is here, the direction is this. So this is your, suppose this is your east and this is your west, this is your north and this is your south. So see, at every instant I am just taking these four directions. Why? Because to make you understand. Otherwise the object is traveling, it is changing its velocity at every instant in the circular motion. ठीक है, जब ऑब्जेक्ट सर्कुलर मोशन करता है तो वहां पर हर एक इंस्टेंट पे वेलोसिटी चेंज होती है, स्पीड कांस्टेंट हो सकती है बट द वेलोसिटी इज कंटिन्यूअसली चेंजिंग बिकॉज द डायरेक्शन इज चेंजिंग। क्यों चेंज हो रही है? क्योंकि डायरेक्शन चेंज हो रही है। सो सी, व्हेन द ऑब्जेक्ट इज हियर द डायरेक्शन इज नॉर्थवर्ड, वेयर व्हेन इट हैज रीच्ड हियर द डायरेक्शन इज वेस्ट, देन हियर व्हेन ही इज रीच्ड हियर द डायरेक्शन इज साउथ, व्हेन ही इज रीच्ड हियर द डायरेक्शन इज ईस्ट। सो इन दिस कंप्लीट मोशन द ऑब्जेक्ट इज चेंजिंग दिस डायरेक्शन and but the speed is same, so it means that the velocity is changing in your circular path. Aapke circular path mein kya change hota hai? Aapki velocity is changing. Okay, so you can write some important, after writing your uniform circular motion, important points. Ye kya hai important points? Pehla hai speed is constant in uniform circular motion. Uniform circular motion में क्या होता है? Speed आपकी constant रहती है. Then second one, velocity changes at every instant of टाइम। वेलोसिटी क्या होती है? आपकी हर एक इंस्टेंट पे चेंज हो जाती है। देन थर्ड, थर्ड इज यू कैन राइट हियर थर्ड पॉइंट, व्हाट इज द अनदर पॉइंट, द फोर्स रिस्पॉन्सिबल, वी विल डिस्कस दिस, फोर्स रिस्पॉन्सिबल टू मेक एन ऑब्जेक्ट move in circular path is centripetal फोर्स, कौन सा फोर्स है? सेंट्रीपिटल फोर्स है। अब वो होता क्या है वो हम देखेंगे अभी। ये आप इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट्स लिख लेना, एंड आफ्टर दिस आई एम गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट दिस लास्ट, दैट इज योर सेंट्रीपिटल फोर्स। ओके, सी दिस इज अ फोर्स व्हिच इज अप्लाइड ऑन अ ऑब्जेक्ट टुवर्ड्स द सेंटर ऑफ द सर्कुलर पाथ। ठीक है, अब देखो क्यों ऐसा होता है, अब क्या है इसके पीछे रीजन, व्हाट इज द रीजन बिहाइंड दिस। दिस इज योर सर्कुलर पाथ, ओके, ये आपका सर्कुलर पाथ है। इफ एन ऑब्जेक्ट इज कंटिन्यूअसली मूविंग इन अ सर्कुलर पाथ, अगर ये मान लीजिए आपने एक थ्रेड को यहाँ पर टाई किया, एंड यू आर हैविंग अ थ्रेड, आपके हाथ में एक थ्रेड है, एंड यू आर जस्ट टाइड अ स्टोन ऑन वन एंड ऑफ द थ्रेड, एंड यू आर जस्ट रोटेटिंग दिस थ्रेड इन सर्कुलर मोशन। सो व्हाट विल हैपन इफ द फोर्स विल नॉट बी देयर, इफ सेंट्रीपिटल फोर्स नहीं होगा तो सो द स्टोन विल मूव अवे, उसी टाइम पर सर्कुलर पाथ में नहीं रहेगा, इट विल गो अवे इन एनी डायरेक्शन। सो दिस सेंट्रीपिटल फोर्स इज अ फोर्स विच बाइंड द ऑब्जेक्ट टूवर्ड्स द सेंटर टू मेक इट रोटेट इन अ सर्कुलर पाथ, वो उसको सर्कुलर पाथ में रोटेट करने के लिए रिस्पॉन्सिबल होता है, एंड इट इज एक्टिंग टूवर्ड्स द सेंटर ऑफ द सर्कल। ये जो आपका सर्कुलर पाथ है इसके सेंटर की तरफ को, ये हर एक इंस्टेंट पे जहां पर भी ऑब्जेक्ट होगा, हर एक इंस्टेंट पे आपका जो फोर्स होगा इट विल बी टुवर्ड्स द सेंटर ऑफ द सर्कुलर पाथ, जो आपका सर्कुलर पाथ है उसके सेंटर पे आपका फोर्स लगेगा, दैट्स व्हाई इट इज नोन एज सेंट्रीपिटल फोर्स। ओके, सो सेंट्रीपिटल फोर्स इज रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर द सर्कुलर मोशन ऑफ द ऑब्जेक्ट। ओके, सो दिस इज द योर, दिस वॉज योर लास्ट टॉपिक। ओके, नाउ we'll proceed towards the next chapter in our next lecture. Okay, till then you revise whatever we have done in this chapter, revise all the lectures. Okay, and I will be going live any day. So you have to subscribe the channel, otherwise you will not get the notification. Okay, so for the live videos you can subscribe the channel, and that day we'll take some queries related to the related to your this chapter. Okay, so till then you revise whatever we have done today and in our previous lectures. Thank you.